watching All the Feels. Last night's Faking It went from romantic dinner date to super awkward group hang when Shane convinced everyone to crash Reagan and Amy's date. I love Remy. Reagan and Amy are so cute together, they have so much in common, and Amy's really happy, but at the same time, I am totally digging jealous karma. Shane told her that lesbians are very territorial, but let's be honest, it was totally karma who was acting territorial over Amy last night, acting way more like a jealous ex than a BFF. Am I right? And karma was not the only one. It was like everyone was playing the jealousy card last night. Shane trying to make Duke jealous, Lauren trying to make Theo jealous, and in some cases it totally worked. Like when Lauren and Theo got together, I was like, finally, yes! I'm so excited, this is the moment I've been waiting for. I just want them to be together. And meanwhile, we've got Liam, who is the voice of reason in this episode. What? He's the one telling Karma to back off and let Amy figure out her relationship with Reagan on her own. This episode caused so many feels that I was like, we need to get to the bottom of this. So today, we are traveling back in time to talk with Faking It showrunner Carter Covington. Time traveling, here we go! So this episode is huge because Karma finally meets Reagan. And I was wondering if you could also tell us why Amy didn't tell Reagan about Karma.
I think that that's because she's so close to Karma that she knew that Reagan would be intimidated by that. And I think that's a really realistic fear. You know, like, that's not something you really would want to tell on a first date or maybe even like a fifth date.
Also in this episode, we get to see Duke and Shane out and about together. And, you know, Shane brings him to this dinner thinking that, you know, it might help Duke actually come out. But instead it kind of pushes him further into the closet. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, well, I think we are all really interested in seeing Shane really like a guy and have a real connection. And he and Duke really connect. And at first it's just a physical thing, but in 207 we wanted to really evolve their relationship, show that Shane wants to go on dates with him, that he'd like to have him as a boyfriend. And Shane's such an out and proud character that his first assumption is that Duke isn't out because he's not proud of who he is.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Carter. Fun fact, I was totally distracted by Carter's glasses throughout this entire interview. This episode of Faking It had me mind blown, and I cannot wait for next week's. So make sure to leave a comment below or tweet at me and let me know your predictions for next week's episode. I will see you guys on Triple Crush Tuesday. Don't forget to tweet with me. I'm Kristen, and I will see you next week. Yeah.